Welcome to the third and last part of this series. After explaining lights and materials, it is time to have a better understanding of the different render engines and modes. Thea for Rhino can operate in two modes, interactive and production. We will start with the interactive mode, which enables viewport rendering inside Rhino. Three engines can be selected when in interactive mode: Presto AEO, Presto MC, and Adaptive AMC. Presto engines make use of CPU and GPU, giving the fastest results. Let's have a look at Presto AEO first. This engine should be chosen for very fast previews, which accounts mostly for direct lighting and also use ambient occlusion. Presto MC, on the other hand, is more advanced and can be considered as an unbiased-like mode. The third progressive render engine is Adaptive AMC. This engine is unbiased with shortcuts to turn it into a faster and biased engine. Caustics can be disabled and the user is able to set a value for tracing depth. Both of these settings play a significant role to the overall speed and allow the user to choose between speed and unbiased accuracy. Interactive mode in Thea for Rhino can be used inside Rhino's viewports or inside Darkroom. To enable viewport rendering, select Presto MC from the settings and press the play button from the toolbar. Now, to open Darkroom, press stop and click on the Thea Darkroom button. At the new window, select interactive mode, press start and continue working in Rhino while having this window open for visual feedback. All of these render engines, apart from the interactive mode, can also be used in production mode, where once they start rendering, changes to the scene are not transferred to the final rendering. Let's have a look at the two unbiased engines, TR1 and TR2, that only work in production mode. These two engines provide high accuracy and performance. TR1 should be used when rendering exterior scenes, where direct lighting is dominant, while TR2 is optimized to give best results for extremely difficult indirect and caustic lighting. Finally, Adaptive BSD is a biased engine with production mode only. This engine gives user full control of all the features at the expense of setup time and should be used for fast photorealistic renderings and animations. That was the final part of this series. We hope that it helped you understand the basics of Thea for Rhino. Please visit our website for more information. Thank you for watching.